In this video, you're going to hear the depth of Song of Solomon's meaning, guarded, the unimaginable, and beautiful Song of Songs. Song of Solomon is pure, absolute prophecy, and the most beautiful message awaits you in the depth of the song. Because what does Song of Solomon mean? Why is it in the Bible? And what is the deepest meaning of the Woman of Songs? God truly did the impossible in having her sing.
A beautiful song is more than just a pretty melody. It is conveying something. It has meaning. And Song of Solomon is more than just a beautiful love song. It has meaning. Song of Solomon, if you ever wondered why it is in the Bible, it is pure prophecy. The groom's name is encoded in the name of Solomon. Solomon means peace, and he was the literal son of David. Son of David and Prince of Peace are messianic titles. And so thus the groom of songs is none other than the Messiah. So who's the bride? And in the bride there are two levels of prophecy. In the previous video we have spoken about Song of Solomon, speaking of the virgin party, the Christians, where that woman is one of those that love the groom. We've spoken about his name being the oil of the wise. If you've missed that, please watch the previous video, it's essential. But there's a much greater level. Do you remember what was said of the first woman that we encounter in the Bible? She is the helper. In actual fact, she was the only suitable helper of the groom to be found. What is the only suitable helper of the Messiah to be found? Because the groom in Song of Solomon is none other than the Messiah. The only suitable helper of Messiah was taking the wrath of God in the stead of us. It's taking the righteous justice of God, the fiery wrath of God in the stead of us. And the Woman of Songs is exactly that. The woman has got a prophecy in her of the fire and the fire bride. There's a prophecy of the fire, and God actually has the wrath, the fire, the justice, the righteous justice of God. Sing the Song of Songs. Do you understand what that means? It means that God has what is to consume us. Sing of our salvation. It is the song, the message of salvation. It is the song of the Prince of Peace, which is the son of David. In other words, in David's name, in the root ties with boiling. It is the son that took the wrath and the boiling to bring the peace. It's a song that is sung by the fire. Jesus' deathbed's testimony is what Song of Solomon is all about. God loves you, and he is the only one that could have taken that fire bride and call her the mother of life. And yes, there is a prophecy in the first woman. The one that we tend to think of as Eve, she's not called Eve in the Bible. She's Isha. She's the woman. She's the togetherness of fire, Eshatai, with fire. She's the fire bride. She's the only suitable helper. She's the one that comes from him, remember? She was taken from him and redirected at him, given back at him. The fiery justice and wrath of God was separated from and given back to Jesus, the salvation of God. Remember what Adam proclaimed? Chava, mother of life. He turned the wrath of God to the mother of life, because Jesus died and he became the lamb slain. In that unit, in his togetherness with the death, is proclaimed life. He turned the death to the mother of life. There's a prophecy in the woman, and everything that God does, even his justice, is beautiful. Everything that he does is perfect, and only he can turn his perfect justice to sing of love. There's a prophecy in the Woman of Songs, the fiery justice and wrath of God, and therefore we find that it is indeed a woman that sings that song because of the prophecy that God has placed in the woman. And many object to that. They say, no, it can't be a woman. But it is. God says it is. Why? Because of prophecy that God placed in the woman as the suitable helper, the only suitable helper of the groom, is the fiery justice of God. And how unlikely it is. If you think it's unlikely for a woman to sing the Song of Solomon, God is using that reaction in you, in the testimony of the prophecy, because how unlikely is it that the fire, the death verdict, the justice of God can sing our salvation? But he can only by God. And it is the song thus of Solomon. It is the song of the Messiah. And we're going to speak a few more brief videos about some of the verses in Song of Solomon that seem unusual. Her being like a horse in Pharaoh's chariot. Her begging for a kiss. We're going to speak about that. Because when you know who she is, you look at this in a whole new way. And it's dreadfully wondrous what that means. We'll speak about that. Short videos to be uploaded.